Hello everybody, this is the Masked GUI, and this is the first episode of WTF is Redstone. As you can see here, in the top, I already just like made a little world and, you know, kind of just set up a little base. It's a creative world, because, you know, just so I didn't have to go all the way underground and find all the materials and for whatever I'm going to be doing. But, well, that is the question really. WTF is Redstone. And this isn't just going to be another kind of a basic of, like, you know, a tutorial series. It's also going to be a mini one, not too long. It'll just be more me experimenting. Because, I mean, like, if you want to know, like, everything that you can possibly make of Redstone, then Google it, or YouTube it, whatever. And you will surely find out what you want to know. But, that's not what I'm about. This is basically going to be me experimenting, because honestly, I never use Redstone. I don't really know a whole lot. It's only been the past like 1 or 2 days that I've actually really tried to start making things with Redstone. When I programmed a toilet to flush and just a little entrance to a town that I'm working on. That's all I've done with Redstone. So, yeah, I thought I'm going to start fiddling around with it, and I thought I'm also going to start uploading me messing around with this Redstone. So, like, yeah, I'll be learning, and hopefully you'll also be learning by watching me doing stuff. I mean, it's probably not going to be anything massively complicated, because, well, I'm not a genius and I'm not going to be able to figure it out. I could also look up tutorials and stuff on the internet, but I don't want to do that, because I'd rather figure it out on my own. Or, like, I might come up with something by myself that would be pretty cool and, you know, worth showing off. Or else I could just look up the wiki, yeah, but as many of you should already know, in both this and Terraria, I refuse to look up the wiki page for any information. So, yeah, I mean, in my hotbar I have the basics. I've got, like, basic redstone, both types of pistons, levers, buttons, redstone torches, iron doors, redstone repeaters, and then to fill up the last slot, I decided to put in note blocks for now. Because I suppose note blocks really are one of the kind of... Oh wait, I won't actually be able to play note blocks properly in this, because you can't left-click it. But luckily, I'll be able to use redstone to program it. I mean, I suppose, just for my little introduction, I'll just start talking about the basics of things that don't even require redstone. Like, for example, put down an iron door. You can either press this button to open it, or you can set a lever. And the lever stays open until you toggle it, and the button is just time-based. So you go 1, 2, it basically opens, it stays open for about 2 seconds. Well, actually no, 1 second even. So that, it just gives you that little time slot. I'll break that door out of the way, and obviously you have to put a button on both sides. That's pretty basic. And then as well, if you want to have, this is just my little base of operations. There is no ceiling, just because, you know, I don't wanna, you know, just in case, like, it's gonna get high. Now, for example, I'll just use, actually, I think I'll get rid of the note blocks, because I won't be dealing with those just yet. And I'll put down cobblestone. Then in terms of pistons, like, this is here. And then sticky pistons, I think, are better, but they're harder to get because it's slimes are hard to find. So, and you put on a switch here, for example, and you click it, and there we go, the piston pops out, and you close it, and because it's stuck to it, that happens. However, if you have a regular piston, and you put the cobble here, then you switch it on, but when you switch it off, it stays there. So they both have their uses. Like, the sticky pistons are good for if you want to have, like, a door that opens and closes, but that's stronger than an iron or wooden door. And this is good for if you just, well, obviously you want to use something once, you know, it makes enough sense. And then, like, you can just still keep on moving it. But, well, you know. Water's kind of troublesome, as I learned when I was making a toilet system. Because if you have it too high, then once the piston goes up, the water disappears. And then when the piston comes back down, then the water's gone. Because it's just like you placed a new brand new block right there. So you will need to keep like a block of water and then a block another block of water underneath that. And then that's where the whole mechanics start. Sorry if that was a really bad explanation. This is, yeah, I'm afraid nothing much is going to happen in this episode. It's just me kind of more talking about electronics that don't require any redstone. And the thing is as well, if I was on a normal mode, I vaguely know how to make a piston. And sticky pistons is the same thing, pretty much only involving slime. But to be honest, I don't really know how to make that. Something to do with wood and iron and stone and a redstone in the middle, I think. And that's pretty much it. And as well, I don't even know how to make a redstone repeater. If I'm to guess, it involves redstone and possibly levers or wood in some manner. But otherwise, I have no idea, to be perfectly honest. But anyway, what other things are involved? So that's a lot of the stuff you can do with levers and things. And realistically, all you need without redstone is something right next to it. Like I could take away the switch and put it here, and it would work. Or else I could put it here. Okay, having two switches doesn't work. But if I have two there, or whatever, you can't put things on top of them. I'm sorry, my voice keeps on breaking. It doesn't also have to be on the ground though, like you can put it up here. And it'll still work. And it'll work here, and on all the ways. Actually, I'm not sure if it works on this side. Oh yeah, it does, anything adjacent to it. And it's going to test out the limits, and see how far it can go. Won't work up there. Or there. It might work up here though. Yeah, it works up here just because it's adjacent to it again. But everything else is just too far beyond. I'll see if this works. Nope. So that's the only one that works. So it does have to be literally right next to it. Obviously it wouldn't work there, because it's blocking the piston. Ah, my legs! Oops, I was supposed to press 5. That's just the piston smooshing my legs. You can also just use it to push yourself. Oop. But you can't get stuck to it using a sticky piston, sadly. Also, the reason this whole place is like kind of, it used to be more flat than this, but this whole area is all screwed up because I tried making a cannon using obsidian and dynamite, and it didn't work. It almost worked because like the smoke only comes out the turret. Well, obviously, when I say works, I mean more cosmetically. Obviously, it doesn't shoot TNT out of it. Because that's impossible, I think. It's just more that I tried to have the smoke kind of shooting out of it, like a real cannon. But then the huge explosion effect that was added in, the big circles, messed up the whole thing. So I tried to put in a lot of obsidian just to cover up that, but then it didn't look like a cannon. It was just a huge block with a switch on the back. So that didn't really work properly. And then, so yeah, that was me going off the topic. Screw it, you're used to it by now. I mean, any of you who watch my videos regularly will probably be watching this video. And you know, anyone new watching this video, here's learning. I go off the topic a lot, and I don't edit my videos. So, well, yeah, I don't edit my videos. I don't like going through that whole process. So I just do everything one take. It's completely natural. It was completely naturally, so if anything goes wrong, then I stick with it. One problem I have is that you can't put buttons on the ground, but that's, I suppose, what pressure plates are for. Pressure plates also work as a form of activation. Boop, boop, boop. Which is good again for, like, you know, what am I trying to do? I can put a pressure plate here. Oh, right, it doesn't work. So you see, huh? Sorry, but yeah, no. Okay, I'm gonna try something out. This is gonna be the first experiment. Just picture this. Okay, I'm not gonna put down lava because this is all wood. But picture this along here being lava, or like nothingness—a big, huge, gaping hole of death and zombies and spikes and creepers and general death. And so I want this thing here, because when I walk forwards, then it'll push me off as shown earlier on. So if I place this bit of redstone, then... Wait, what? Why isn't this working? I'll place more redstone until something happens. Right, I don't understand why that's not working, because normally I thought redstone, as long as it's adjacent, will work. But I'm obviously wrong. So I'll try to put down this repeater. See? I'm obviously very wrong. So it's very tricky to get working. But if I think... I think if I put the repeater here... No, it lights up, but it doesn't actually activate this piston. So I need to... think again. And I'll try and put it here and see if this works. Now the repeater is not even lighting up. So... obviously, I'm doing something wrong. All I want to do is to activate this. I'll try putting this redstone up here. There we go. Right. Why it didn't work before, I don't know. Maybe it has to be at the same level or something. But it took me this long to figure it out. And that happened. So now if I get rid of this and put this here... that breaks the stream. What I want to do though is have... the repeater set a time delay. Which doesn't seem to be working for me. This is okay. But that's not what I want to happen. Because that blocks me instead of traps me. Which is wrong. So instead, I'm gonna try this and put, say, the repeater here, and then put redstones here and here and here, and see if this works. Apparently not. That works fine though, so I'll try and put the repeater in every possible location till I find the right one. I just don't understand, that one's lighting up, fine, but it's not working normally. Because redstone repeaters are supposed to do other things other than light up. But I just don't get it. Right, okay, this video's almost over. And I hope this is a good introduction, and this is pretty much what's going to be happening over the next few episodes. Me trying. And hopefully I will come to some discoveries. So, I hope you enjoyed this episode, and stay tuned for more.